Ah, yes, the most common of all carpet seams, the doorway seam. In this video, we're going to break it down how to go ahead and do this like a boss, no problems whatsoever, because you are an inner carpet pro. That's a horrible title to have. But first things first, let's go ahead and walk you through how to do this seam. Take a super sharp blade and put a nice fresh edge on the carpet there. Now, if you do not have a good steady hand, go ahead and throw a straight edge on it and trace it all the way down. Next, we're gonna cut down the sides of the other piece of carpet that's under it that we're gonna seam to. So when we're done, we can just tuck and go and life is good. So all right, push that down. Whoo, okay, that's where our seam's gonna fall. Make sure that blade is still razor sharp. Watch those fingertips and go ahead and make little incisions on the carpet that we need to cut still. We're gonna play a game of connect the dots after this. So go ahead and work your way all the way across. Boom, boom. All right, fold it back. Fold that one back. Okay, cool. Now we're gonna go ahead and see all these little dots right here. We're gonna take our knife and we're gonna run it along all those and make a nice clean edge so both pieces are able to be seamed together. And once again, if you can't keep a steady hand playing connect the dots there, just put a straight edge from dot to dot to dot to dot to dot to dot to dot, and you will have a perfect seam template to go ahead and get these two lined up perfectly. Now, they're both cut, ready to rock. We gotta get a little bit of seam tape under here. Rip that off, and we want to cut it collectively about 4 inches hefty. We're going to fold it under at each end, about 2 inches on each side. Reason we're doing that is we need it to beef up on top of the tack strip. If you don't do that, the first inch and the last inch will not burn evenly, and you'll have to, you know, throw staples in it or something. So if you fold it under, it'll pop it up a little bit. You get a nice even burn from start to finish. Now, drop that seam iron in there as we just did. We're gonna let that cook for a good 8 to 10 seconds in one spot. Once it's nice and goopy warm, we're gonna go ahead and pinch the back, slide it an iron's length forward. Then we're gonna stop and let that area start cooking up there. And you could always sneak a peek behind the iron, because when you see dry glue, you know you went too far. Just slowly back it up if you did that. If not, just go ahead and put together the first part. And when you're putting your seam together, you don't just smash it down. You want to make sure it's backing to backing lining up and no fibers are getting in the mix of it. Fibers get down in there, it gets gooped up, and you have one ugly visible seam. That's the last thing we want in this scenario. We want to be nice and perfectly blended, all that good stuff. So once the seam iron gets to the other edge there, we're gonna go ahead and give it a hot second there, and then we're gonna swoop it out. And when we swoop it out, there's a little bit of technique to it. Make sure you're watching it, just because if you pull it out, the seam tape could come with it, get glue on top of the carpet, and it's a hot mess. You see I did that swoop action there? That keeps the tape in place, so it gives you time to work the carpet down into it, just like I did there. Boom, put it together, blend it in with your fingertips, and then you could just tuck in each side, and bam, you officially graduated carpet seam school. Thank you so much for tuning into this. I look forward to connecting with you in the next video.